Oh, dear, it's getting toward dark now, and so you'll have to put it off till morning. But you will find him in the morning, won't you? Promise?
I'll have him here by daylight.
Oh, now you're your own old self again, and lovelier than ever.
I couldn't ask fairer than that. Good-bye, dear. Sally mused a moment alone, then said earnestly,
I love him in spite of his name,
and went about her affairs with a light heart. End of chapter 24. The American Claimant by Mark Twain. Chapter 25. Hawkins went straight to the telegraph office and disburdened his conscience. He said to himself, She's not going to give this galvanized cadaver up. That's plain. Wild horses can't pull her away from him. I've done my share. It's for Sellers to take an innings now. So he sent this message to New York. Come back. Hire special train. She's going to marry the materializee. Meantime, a note came to Rossmore Towers to say that the Earl of Rossmore had just arrived from England, and would do himself the pleasure of calling in the evening. Sally said to herself,
It is a pity he didn't stop in New York, but it's no matter. He can go up tomorrow and see my father. He has come over here to tomahawk Papa, very likely, or buy out his claim. This thing would have excited me a while back, but it has only one interest for me now, and only one value. I can say to Spinal, I don't like any form of that name. I can say to him tomorrow, don't try to keep it up any more, or I shall have to tell you whom I have been talking with last night, and then you will be embarrassed.
Tracy couldn't know he was to be invited for the morrow, or he might have waited. As it was, he was too miserable to wait any longer, for his last hope, a letter, had failed him. It was fully due today. It had not come.